right, mild temperatures continue this afternoon. Temperatures in the 60s area. Why? We had a weak boundary that went through during the day today. That's why we have the cloudy skies, few light showers down towards South Mississippi. But other than that, people have been dry for today around here. Numbers again, a warm near 70 down towards Macomb, and that's where the boundary is from Natchez to Macomb. Temperatures are a lot warmer, but you get north of that boundary, some cooler air trying to filter in, and temperatures in the lower 60s. It's going to be a mild night tonight and a mild day tomorrow. Temperatures pushing 70 for the next 2 days. Then we have a big New Year's Eve storm that is taking shape. And here it is right now over California. Big dip in the jet stream. Big storm energy now coming onto the coast of California. And this is going to move across the Four Corners region. And a pretty intense storm system going to be developing here over Texas. And that's going to move toward our area. It's going to bring a round of showers and maybe some strong thunderstorms to parts of the area New Year's Eve. So here's a look at the map today. There's the front that went through, but again, we're going to be mainly cloudy. We're not going to clear out much this week, but it is going to be mild. Temperatures, like I said, going back up to near 70 degrees. So these are the lows for tonight. Again, upper 40s, near 50, 47 here in the metro, 45 Carthage, near 50 down towards the Natchez area. And then tomorrow, temperatures back up in the 60s. A warm day. The winds are going to be out of the southeast, becoming breezy later on in the day. 65 the high around here. So there's the map tomorrow. Again, a warm front. The front that came through is going to stall out and then try to move back to the north as a warm front tomorrow. So mild conditions, mostly cloudy skies, a gusty southeast wind developing. Here's our developing storm. Snow and ice for portions of the Great Plains, and rain and thunderstorms developing for Oklahoma into Texas. Now, this front is going to near the area on Wednesday. There could be some showers late. I think the main action is going to be Thursday for our area as an intense area of low pressure develops here in Texas and moves to the north. That's going to drag in more moisture, more instability, and that means that we are setting ourselves up for the potential for some strong thunderstorms. So there's the map on Thursday. Here's the area of low pressure developing. Again, it's going to be a strong south wind on Thursday, gusty, and rain and thunderstorms moving through late in the day. Should be out of here by New Year's Day. I think New Year's Day, we start off the day cloudy, but we clear out during the day. But it's going to be a cool day. Temperatures only topping out in the 50s. And there's that big storm racing to the east. Again, showers and thunderstorms from Georgia all the way up to Virginia. So here's a severe weather threat. Again, isolated severe thunderstorms are possible from the metro area down to the south. If you want to hone it down even more, thinking probably off to our east is going to be where the highest threat of severe weather going to be. Gusty winds and some spin-up tornadoes are going to be the main threats with this system moving through. 47 degrees tonight. The clouds hang around. It's going to be cool, though, but milder than average. Tomorrow, highs will be in the mid-60s. Breezy, warm, mostly cloudy. Those winds gusting at times up to 20 miles an hour. And then there's your 7-day forecast. You can see temperatures on the warm side Wednesday and Thursday near 70. New Year's Day, temperatures near 50, a cool day. And then as we head towards the weekend and the first week of 2021, looking average, temperatures in the mid-50s.